Defining our body type by using a piece of fruit is an outdated shorthand. It doesn't really tell us much, except it reminds us where our flaws are. So my med unit poured through the latest research because we know more than ever about why your fat deposits where it does. So here's the question for all of you. Which new body type are you? Take a look.
Stand in front of the mirror. Where's the largest concentration of your body fat? Do you carry weight around your midsection, between your chest and hip bone? If so, you may be the stress type. Turn, do you see pinchable fat on the side, AKA love handles? Then you might be the sugar type. Fat around your hips, butt, and thighs? Maybe you're the estrogen type. Raise your arms. Excess skin under there? You could be the T type. The science is in. Knowing which of these four new body types fits you can help you maximize your weight loss results.
So look at these types again. It's important to know which one you are. You can be a combination of more than one. I'm gonna post the quiz on DrOz.com as well so you can find yourself. Now that you know your new body type, what you eat to maximize your weight results can be determined. Let's start with the stress type. These are the people who hold the fat around their belly. How are you? Christina?
Good to meet you.
Thanks for being here, and thanks for talking about this.
Sure.
So some people would have called you an apple in the past, some would have called you some other kind of fruit, who cares? We're not talking about a whole different way of defining you. It's a stress type. So explain, if you can, to me how stress affects the way you eat and the way you feel about your body.
So whenever I feel a little stressed out, I'm always snacking. So I snack at all different times of the day, sometimes at night, sometimes right before I go to bed. I'm always snacking, munching on something, and then, you know, the pounds come on and they land right here.
It does, yeah. In the middle.
Yeah.
Can I just explain one thing?
Sure.
When I show this to Lavatar, this is not pinchable fat.
Right.
This is fat that's actually deep under the muscle. It's
right.
Fat around the organs. Are you all clear on that? That's really important to determine. And the reason you get this kind of weight is because of the stress.
Right.
And yes, the stress makes you eat things you shouldn't, but the stress also very specifically makes you put cortisol out.
Right.
The cortisol says, whoa, wait a minute, you're gonna be in a bad situation. Things aren't good. Maybe it's like a famine. So store all the calories and put them around my intestines, around right. my liver, so I've got myself protected. So you're, although your body's trying to help, it's doing the wrong thing for
right.
you. It creates this stress type collection of fat, which tends to be sort of dangerous because
right.
it leads to so many of the issues that we fear, things like
right.
heart disease and like. We don't want that. So your solution is pretty simple. You're gonna try, if you can, to eat carbohydrates, but the right kind.
Okay.
Because they're gonna soothe you, and you're gonna want that warm. You know why? Think about this. The carbs, of course, we all know that. They, you know, they makes more of that feel-good hormone, serotonin. But the warmth also soothes you and helps de-stress you.
Right.
So what I'm asking you to do is, you know, do the regular things that are good for your body, but add to it something to address what your main problem is,
okay.
which is the stress. So I'll come over here. I got a little idea for you.
Okay.
This could be your breakfast going forward. I sort of took one of our day off diet morning smoothies and I modified it.
Okay.
So it's a little bit of, you know, some yogurt, this is almond butter, some flax seeds that have been, you know, squashed or they've
okay.
been ground up, right? The banana. Then you're going to add some oatmeal.
Okay.
Oatmeal is a complex carbohydrate.
Okay.
It's not going to rush into your bloodstream, not going to panic your body,
okay.
but it's soothing. And then you're going to microwave it
okay.
for a minute. And when you do that, you've got this, a morning smoothie. That's an antidote to the stress type weight gain that so many folks complain about. Give it a
okay.
taste, see if you enjoy it. But this is the kind of thing you want to do to relax yourself,
mm-hmm.
stop penalizing yourself, and realize I deal with the stress with a little bit of nudge with the right foods,
okay.
and all of a sudden, I can make myself look the way I want to look. Thanks
I'm
for
game.
Starting this off. You game?
Thank you.
So let's move on to this sugar type, those who hold the fat around their middle, and they have a little bit of those love handles. Valerie volunteered herself as being the sugar type. Do you love sugar?
I do, yes.
What's your favorite sweet?
Oh, chocolate.
Mm.
Yes.
Dripping, oozing chocolate.
Oh, all the time.
All right, so here's the deal. The problem with sugar is insulin. If it wasn't for the darn insulin, it wouldn't be a big deal. But when you have a lot of sugar, the insulin has to deal with it. And when you make more insulin, guess what it does? It says store the sugar as fat.
Oh.
And it then very meticulously goes to certain parts of your body. In many cases, it'll become those love handles.
Yeah.
So to deal with it, you have to use sugaring-lowering techniques. And so
okay.
these are my specialty.
Oh, yeah.
Now, but this actually looks like a pancake, doesn't it?
Yes.
Please taste this. And as you're tasting, I'll describe what this is. This, my friends, is a mashed banana with two eggs. Then I put a little cinnamon on there. Again,
oh,
there's no flour.
So good.
Isn't that good?
Yes.
Who would have thought? Eggs and banana, look at a pancake. And with this, you won't have the problem with the insulin. The other thing you can do is replace the taste, so you don't need the sugar. So garlic and oregano and sage, these are herbs that take you in a different direction than sugar, so you won't feel compelled to put sugar in your body.
Okay.
You do this and pay attention to some of the day off diet ideas, and you'll see the fat coming off, especially at the love handle area.
Awesome.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, next. I promised you all the most popular type would be mentioned, and that happens to be the estrogen type. These are folks who store their fat around their hips and their thighs. And Stacey, you're very honorable to come up here, but you were holding a pear earlier, I understand.
Yes, I was.
So folks, when their childbearing years are progressing, you will often not only have a lot of estrogen, but you'll have strong PMS symptoms as well if you're one of these estrogen storage people.
I do. I have very bad PMS. I get tired, too. I'm tired, and I want to overeat and not eat these foods that are sitting here.
No. Why would I put these foods here? These are vegetables, right? But they're not just any vegetable. And here's the big story. If you want to deal with the estrogen, you actually have to deal with the foods you're eating because they can help block the estrogen. So come on back here. You know, on the broad diet plans that we're offering, like the day off diet as an example, what I love to do is say, eat non-starchy veggies because you can eat as much of the stuff as you want. All these great things, the asparagus, the bamboo shoots, the beans. However, this bottom column here, the bottom row, these are the cruciferous vegetables. And they very specifically seem to help us deal with estrogen levels. So if you eat the Brussels sprouts, the broccoli, the cabbage, the cauliflower, the daikon, kale, turnip, find these and make them part of what you're eating. And we'll put some recipes up on DrOz.com to help.
Oh, I'd love that.
The T-type. Those are the folks who have trouble building muscle, and they therefore have a little excess flab and skin on their arms. And Robin is here to help with this.
That would be me.
Yes. Yeah, you can all do it right. Everyone put their arms up. I think they're in a T right here. And you can find yourselves in this. The T-types, you know, we're the shape of T when you put our arms out, but the T actually stands for testosterone. They tend to have low muscle mass without a ton of muscle. Make their arms ring again one time. Without a ton of muscle here, you leave room for this. Yeah. And so we want to build muscle.
Yes. Thank
you. And you don't want to take testosterone to do that.
No.
So the question is, how do you actually have it happen? And a big problem for a lot of Americans is they don't have enough vitamin D, and that impacts on their testosterone levels.
Okay.
So I want you to include foods, include a tool to get you more vitamin D. You can go out in the sun a little bit if you want as well, but it's hard to do, especially in the winter months. So I want you, for lunch or dinner, a couple times a week, to include a protein that has vitamin D in it. Classically, these are cold water fish, so salmon, sardines. Do you like sardines?
I've not ever had sardines.
You haven't?
Never.
Well, we have a learning opportunity here.
Yes, we do.
Here, open your mouth. All right, I'll do it. Oh, come on now, you all know that trick. These are real sardines. That's a raw sardine, I'm not gonna give that to you.
Okay.
But I do want you to try this.
I will.
And go ahead and take that.
Thank you.
I like to eat it this way, with my fingers. I know some people taste cat food when they taste this, but it's not true.
It's pretty good. It's not bad at all.
And it's got vitamin D in it. Now, if you can't do that, probably need a vitamin D supplement. So the folks who are the T's, one way or the other, supplement's probably the safest, but one way or another, get your vitamin D levels in there.
Okay.
Thank you very much
for that.
Now, here's the deal. I'm going to power up this plan by posting an exercise guide to target all four body types on my Facebook page and Pinterest board. That's what it looks like. Make sure you share it with your family and your friends. Do those little activities to support the foods that you eat differently, and you'll be able to customize your program for your body type. Be sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss anything. And remember to check back often to see what's new.